So here we are at night in Nurnberg. Started out with quite a few cars in this thing. I don't think most of them, like me, realized that it was going to be a night thing. Luckily, there was some lights scattered about because it was pretty dark. I guess I should have hit the brakes on that one. But live and learn. As you can see, there was some contact here and there. And I didn't know there was a proximity alert that I could have turned on in this thing, but I had it off, so. Was that guy trying to puncture my tires or what? When the clouds aren't in the way, the moon looked pretty good in that one shot. Looked like a full moon. Luckily, it wasn't raining, and raining at night is really bad. Right now, I'm just trying to survive the darkness. But spoiler alert, the sun never comes up. I know you can hear me on the mic, I just don't know if you can actually hear the engine sounds and all that from the race. Haven't been able to figure out on how to get all that stuff working on these replays when I'm trying to capture it to share it on whatever service I decide to share it on. So if it's just me talking, if that's all you can hear, I do apologize. Just barely make out that there's little lights on top of the poles at that chicane. That's the only point of reference you got when you're going through there. And this guy here, he's a bad dude. This guy's a bad dude that I'm trailing right now. It's the guy that's number four on that list to the left. Taruk Makto. Not sure what his problem was, but it was he decided to mug me by vehicle. As you can see, I don't think I did anything to instigate it. And he didn't stop. Ouch! Call an ambulance. Took me a while to figure out what the reset car button was on the controller. Now it's a matter of trying to limp back to the pits. So if you happen to be racing Toruk, Macdo, beware. I don't think he's a very clean racer. Not that I'm a gentleman racer, but he's a lot dirtier than I am. He tried taking me out there, and luckily for me, he missed. Finally made it to pit road. Get in here and get repaired and get back out. I didn't realize the pit crew would be invisible here. And you can't hear them banging on the car either to fix it. And there he is. There's the guy that took me out. He's in pits too. Thank God. I'll get out before he does. By the way, these F3s are pretty fun to drive. I didn't see much in the way of being able to set it up. Not that I would know how to set it up, but I'm definitely not as quick as some of those people that were out there, but at least I was able to keep it on track, unless I was getting mauled. But, spoiler alert, I may have some spins in my future. All by myself. This turn here was really hard to see going in, and then this right-hander here, it was hard to find the entry point on that too. Of course, trying to find my entry on the chicane was really tough too. Luckily, it had those little lights there. At least this front stretch is lit up here so you could see what's going on here. But then hitting your marks getting into turn one was kind of tough for me. Oops! Not exactly sure what happened there. Must have tried to get in the gas a little too hard, maybe? I don't know. And we're counting down. We have 12 and a half minutes to go this wonderful video. Whoops. Again, I must have tried getting on the power a little too quick or something. Not exactly sure what happened. I think since we have less than 9 minutes to go, I tried pushing the car a little bit, and I think I was able to set my quickest time of the race in the closing laps here. Couldn't get down into those 207s that two of the players that you see on the left have done, but I was able to get it under 210, I think. And I think that was as low as I could go, the 208, 680. There's only just over 4 minutes left, but that was my quickest lap of the thing, was the 208 something. Got a little loosey-goosey on that one, too. I didn't realize they could turn all that stuff off. Now you don't know what's going on. Sorry, I didn't realize it would just want to play it again. But that was it. Multiplayer on Automobilista 2 in Nurnberg, Germany, in an F3 car. I have to try and get my way to the are the screens. It's a shame I can't get the taskbar here. So, as you can see, other things I have race room, R Factor 2, and I got those goofy ones, the flat out ones. But I'm going to try putting out some videos on that stuff, and I also have a set of Corso Competizioni. So, look for more videos. Take care, folks.